So we're going to make pizza dough. Now, it's a really lovely thing to make, but it's quite a lot of work. Is it worth it?
Oh, of course it's worth it. Just give me anybody who doesn't love pizza, and especially one you make yourself. Believe me, it's not that much work.
Okay.
So easy to do. Okay, we're going to start off. We've got 400 grams of strong white flour. Compared to your normal cake flour, your biscuit flour, this is much higher in gluten, which gives us a much more elastic, stretchy dough. It's what we want for our pizza.
Okay, could you use plain flour or not?
If you're stuck and you're that's all you have in your cupboard, yeah, use it. You'll get away with it, but obviously it's not as good as this.
Okay.
Next, we want 100 grams of semolina.
So that makes it that lovely crispy crust.
Exactly,
that gives
yeah.
it that.
Next, we want to take 2 teaspoons of salt. I know everyone's like very conscious about salt and stuff these days, but your bread needs it.
Yeah.
It's a natural flavour enhancer, controls your yeast, and believe me, it'll taste horrible without it.
So let's get it
yeah,
in
get
there.
It, throw it in. All we're going to do is just mix all the dry ingredients together. Next, we're going to go for 1.5 teaspoons of dried yeast. If you can get your hands on fresh yeast, use that. About 15 grams of fresh if you have it. The one thing to know about yeast is, in concentrated amounts, salt will kill it. So never put yeast in direct contact with salt. That's why you always mix your salt in.
Ah, okay. So you mix your salt first, then get your yeast
Yeah, because like, even though we need it to control it, yeah. make sure it's blended in. Okay, so next we need water. You hear a lot about water. Is it hot? Is it cold? Do I have to heat it first? Cold tap is fine.
Okay, cold
tap.
Work
absolutely fine.
Pouring it in?
Yeah, straight in the center. There's about 275 mils. If it needs a little bit more, then we can add it later.
Okay.
Next, we're just going to add in about 50 mils of olive oil.
So how much is 50?
You pour, I'll say stop.
Okay, right.
It's about 2 shots worth. Yeah, that'll do. So all we're going to do is just grab a wooden spoon and simply just mix it all together. Once it's come together, straight out of the work surface.
Yeah. People are quite terrified of making bread or making dough and getting it wrong and thinking that there is a technique that they don't know.
Yeah, I don't really understand why people are so scared of it. Because bread is so, it can be so simple.
Yeah, but that's because you're brilliant.
No, but it's quite forgiving as well. You see. But I hope it is.
Now, I notice you're using hardly any flour.
Well, you don't need it. Obviously, everyone's reaction is, oh, it's wet, it's sticky, you better throw a little handful of flour in.
Yeah.
But the thing is, your dough is going to keep soaking that up. So obviously, your dough is going to dry out, it's going to be tighter, and we want like a really wet, kind of supple, really soft dough.
Okay.
So this is just like a little dough scraper. Any kitchen shop, you pick one up. If you've got a plastic lid,
yes.
make one, cut it up.
I've made one out of an ice cream tub. I didn't realise you could actually buy one. I love this.
So you can feel it now. It's quite wet and sticky, so a little trick. Stop it sticking.
Yeah. Ace, I love that trick.
So just a little bit. So this is where you get to take out your frustrations of the day. All you do is stretch in the dough. You'll all kind of push it away.
Yeah.
Pull it back in. Like some people, you can really get it down. Stretch it.
And that's the way that I was taught, was that folding in
yeah.
and folding out.
Because again, you stretch it. So
yeah.
it's the same
okay.
kind of same principle. Don't worry, there's no kind of foolproof way of doing it. Just don't be gentle. It's really give it a good workout.
Okay.
Wanna have a go?
Yeah. If there's no foolproof way, what are you actually wanting to do with this?
Once you hydrate flour, that's
yeah.
when the gluten forms. And simply what you want to do is really work that gluten. Get
okay.
it really stretchy and elastic.
Really hard work, is it? It's quite nice work. So how long do you need to do this for?
Roughly about 10 minutes, but largely depends on how you need.
Okay.
If I do this for 10 minutes, I'll be nowhere. But if you really...
Okay.
It could be quicker. Because the first time you do it, it could be more like 15 to 20 minutes maybe. It's like the first time you run a mile.
Yeah, okay.
It says 5 minutes. No, it doesn't. It's way longer. What we're looking for is what we call the window pane. You should be able to stretch it, that you can, the light almost passes through it, like
yeah.
a window. So you can see it's almost there, but it's still kind of tearing.
Yes.
So it means it's very close. You need 1 minute or 2 more kneading, and we're done. Okay, let's have a little look. You can see the light kind of coming through it.
Yeah.
We might say 10 minutes, but let the dough
yeah.
tell you. It'll tell you when it's ready. Our baby. It's there.
I love it.
So you've got a nice smooth elastic dough. You can see how much has changed. Nice clean bowl. Just a little drop of oil. We're just going to pop our dough into our bowl and we're going to set aside to prove.
And how long will that take?
Rough guide, 60 minutes to an hour and a half, depending on how warm it is. What you're really looking for is your dough to double in size. Don't worry if it's a little bit longer, just give it time.
Okay.
And all we're going to do, a little damp cloth, just to stop the dough from drying out. Drape it over, and we pop it to one side.
Great.
Now this one's had 60 minutes. We'll see. Have a look and see how it's doing.
Wow, look at him. He's grown.
The yeast, it converts all the sugars and starches. That's what makes it rise. It's quite springy. You can feel all that air.
Yeah, amazing.
So you know it's alive. The whole reason for proving, this is like where we turn, say, average bread into great bread. Because this is where all the flavour develops.
This is where the magic happens.
Indeed. So now at this stage, once I have it proven, we need to knock it back. Literally, it's just knocking the air out of the dough. Like we're stopping it in its tracks, stopping the proving cycle, and it's starting all over again. If you let your dough overprove,
yeah,
it's going to start affecting the structure of your dough. It's going to start to break down.
Okay.
So literally, really, physically, knock it back.
That's knocking it back.
Stretch it out.
So by knocking it back, literally, what you're doing is literally getting it out there and punching the air out of it.
Literally knocking it out.
Knocking the air out.
So don't be, yeah, this is where people kind of...
Oh, I could feel it. I could feel that air in there. Okay.
So that's exactly what we want now at this stage. So now what we're going to do is start like a whole new cycle. We're going to make two portions.
Yeah.
So use our dough scraper and split it in two.
Yeah.
So ball your hand in and roll it around. Kind of cup it in both your hands. And then we should have a nice little smooth ball. So now that we've got our two equal portions, I'm going to set them aside, just give them a little bit of a rest.
Okay.
Literally, if you go straight in there with your rolling pin, you see the dough naturally wants to shrink?
Yeah.
And all you're going to do is keep fighting against yourself and fighting against the dough. If you just imagine you just knock that dough out, really beating it up. So I want to give the poor guy a chance to recover. If someone punched you in the stomach, you'd want a little break after it too. So that's exactly the same thing here.
Yeah.
Cover this over.
Yeah.
I'm just going to pop it to one side. So in an ideal world, 30 minutes, 40 minutes, and you can see.
Oh, wow, yes.
And again, you can feel it nice and light.
Yeah, sorry.
Squidging. Nice and full of air. No, that's fine.
Lovely.
So at this stage, yeah, we're pretty much ready to get rolling.
Okay.
So a little bit of our semolina left, which is going to add to our crust, but a good crispy base to it also. Using your knuckles.
Yep.
A little quarter turn. Just keep your dough moving.
Yours is a perfect circle.
Yeah, but it's pizza. It can be any shape it wants to be.
No, but mine wants to be perfect. So what's this twist thing you're doing now?
Well, it's because you've got the rolling pin. But all you're doing is kind of using kind of your knuckles and kind of stretching out the dough. Just let it bounce.
Nice, simple toppings.
For me, can't beat the classic cheese and tomato.
And I'm just going to do half of mine with cheese.
Yeah. And now, yum, you've got your little calzone. Or your own pasty.
Yeah.
Like. So what we need to do, we need to get our oven preheated.
Okay.
This is like one of the few times you want your oven as high as it'll possibly go. Literally crank it up till it won't turn anymore, just get it in there.
Okay.
So if you have a pizza stone, get that in, get it preheated. But if you don't, everyone's got a roasting tray.
Yeah.
Turn it upside down, stick that in your oven. Give it a good 15, 20 minutes if you can, just to get it roasting hot.
Okay.
You know, you're at the pizza parlors and pizza shops, they've got their own little peel. Yeah, we're gonna make our own.
Okay.
All it is a chopping board. Your pizza on. So we're just gonna pop this into the oven. All we're doing, sliding it straight on. And about 8 minutes and we should be done.
Yes.
So I'll just leave you to wash up.
Yeah, great. I actually don't mind. You all right there?
Oh yes, here we go.
Wow. It's gorgeous.
And not to mention, the calzone.
Great.
And we're done.
They look gorgeous.
But you can see they're all puffed up. Yeah, well, there is one stage left, and that's
okay.
Get tucked in.
It's delicious. you know what? I think it's made all the more delicious by the love that you put into it when you're making it. It's good. Mine's as good as yours.
Yeah. Almost.